And now, please join me in welcoming Gigi Mitchell-Velasco.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That's actually, I just love that piece. It's a very divisive piece. Our organist friends either love it or hate it, and I love it. I think it's a lot of fun. It was written by an Anglican composer. He was born in England, but he has local roots, which is really kind of cool. In, I believe it was 1962, he was invited by the Church of the Advent in Boston to come and be their organist and music director. And not only is that one local root, but I live in Providence, and James Busby, a Boston resident, is church, St. Stephen's Church, and he was a very good friend of John Cook. And when he died, Mr. Busby went and conducted the choir, and the choir for his memorial was made up of all of Cook's friends. So that's a nice local tidbit there. The next piece is, or I should say the next two pieces I'll tell you about, which is Georg Böhm and Johann Sebastian Bach. Bach is no stranger to anyone, even non-musicians know, ta-da! So they all know Bach in that way. But Böhm, there's no connection that's a definitive connection, but it's believed by his biographer, Bach's biographer back in the day, Forkel, that Bach was a pupil of Böhm. But it's certainly definitely in letters and written that he was very much influenced by him and they didn't know each other. So whether or not he was a student or not is still up for grabs. But this piece, Vater Unser in Himmel Reich, which is Our Father Who Art in Heaven, is the Lord's Prayer, more or less, is the Böhm selection. And then the other selection that follows that, I thought I'd put the two friends together, teacher and student, or friends. The Bach is the C minor fantasy. This is Van Persen Fantasies. And the fantasy is like an aria, and it's very akin to the beautiful Böhm melody that you'll hear before the fantasy and fugue.
Thank you.
Thank you. So that ends the Baroque and early music part of our program. I know a lot of you love earlier music and Baroque music, but I'm going to convince you to love the other stuff. I'm going to do it. I have a wonderful piece up next that is from a larger work of called Son and Tina. And this piece, to me, well, it was written by Sowerby, and Sowerby at one point was called the Dean of American Church Music. So he has written anthem symphonies, I believe symphonies. He's written organ works, the most famous of which all organists know, the unplayable pedal part of the Paget, which is just brutal, but it's a fantastically exciting piece. And this little sonatina that he wrote probably early on, I don't actually know, I should say, but this is a cross between Langlais and Gershwin. It's very jazzy. He was influenced by jazz, and you can hear the jazz in it. It's called Very Slowly, so he wasn't kidding. It is very slow. But do enjoy the harmonies, and some will make you uncomfortable. Some will make you feel like ordering a cocktail. So it will be a very different experience as far as sonically. It's different. But you'll always find when you get to that uncomfortable sonority, it has this wonderful opening and this wonderful resolution. So I hope you enjoy Very Slowly from the Sonatina of Leo Sowerby.
Requires all hands on deck and all feet on deck.
Thank you.
Like modern music now?
Yes, it's jazzy, I tell you. You can have a little cocktail next to your chair and just, I guess we can't do that in church. I guess that's the Episcopal Church. Okay. Anyway, this next piece is a piece that I have, and I'm going to give a little demonstration so you can appreciate it even more. It is very complicated as far as, you know, the feet and the hands and the pieces. But, you know, the whole idea is, it was an improvisation. And this first appeared on 78 that Dornemeyer, the composer, had made along with five other pieces of Sedan Franck. And an autobiography was coming out of Franck, and he made this little 78 recording. And his student, who I'm sure you've heard of Durflay, if you love organ music, Durflay, first of all, Turner said, I don't have any desire to ever have any of this written down, so please, you know, all you guys, don't write it down. So what if Durflay didn't, he wrote it down. So that's students for you. But I think he wanted to immortalize his teacher, and oddly enough, this ends up being, I wouldn't say the most popular among concert organists, because concert organists have a wide repertoire and a wide palette of what they like. But this particular piece is probably the most known to the widest number of organists, this Victim in Ascari. And it is supposed to be an Easter entrance. It is a chant, Gregorian chant, which is what Dornemeyer was famous for improvising on. And the interesting part about that, he's setting up all this stuff. I'm going to actually just play the chant for you so you can recognize it in the music, because it happens over and over and over in the pedal of the hands and everywhere. It's a very interesting notion. Like I said, it's supposed to be Easter, but October the 31st, Dornemeyer, who was a diabetic, I understand, he took a walk and he never came back. So, and they found that he had died. So this is kind of his death time, so we can memorialize him in this way by playing this piece, not just at Easter, but now's a good time to celebrate his death anniversary. I will tell you a fun note about this before I begin is that I have been working on this piece for a very long time, and I've tried to program it, and every time I program it, the concert gets canceled, something happens. So I probably programmed this like four times. This may be anticlimactic, I don't know. Maybe I can't play it anymore. I know I can play it a couple years ago. I've just been working on it, so I said, I'm playing this no matter what. Even if nobody comes and the concert's canceled, I'm just going to come here and play it anyway. just to get it done. So here is the chant. I'm just going to actually lean over here and actually I could probably, yeah, it's 92. Oh, by the way, please give my husband, Noel Velasco, a hand for his registering. Was an opera singer and he sang all over the world and has nothing to do with the organ, and he's the best registrant I think I've ever seen in my life. He's done all kinds of things for me. So, but as that old line about Anna Russell said, he taught me everything I knew, including singing. So, I'm gonna put this thing off and I'll just holler at you before I begin, and I'm gonna play the chant for you.
Because this is ungainly.
Thank you.
again, and you are my first victim, Ace. Please support this program. Please support this church. They're lovely people. This is my third concert here. I canceled last year, and thank you very much for coming.